You sit there in my shadows, and you call it your relief. Don't be the one with bad eyes for the things that I could see. Don't give me that.
I was incredibly optimistic throughout the entire process. It was a lot of work, just getting all those kids signed up, getting them in, getting in their places, understanding who had an amp, who didn't, who had cables, etc., etc., etc. Not to mention 30 kids asking questions, each of them 5 questions every 2 minutes. That's something, right? That's a lot. It started, and it was absolutely atrocious. The noise that happened, the frequencies, there wasn't a missing frequency from low to high. Anything you can imagine. It sounded like being inside of a tidal wave of children. We looked at each other and we were like, what have we gotten ourselves into? Right? What have we done? Day 2, 100% better. We immediately started talking about song structure. Taking these kids and teaching them what song structures are, made them understand it. We came up with a common language so that no matter what, all of us were speaking the same. Day 3, we were playing songs. And that was impressive. Day 3, we started learning a song, and by the end of the day, we had learned a song. And day 4, we had learned, by the end of that day, we had learned 3 songs. Dominic had only been playing for 3 or 4 months. I'm telling you, the kid improved 400% within 5 days. 5 days, 400%. This kid started having an understanding of rhythm, and he worked. He wrote his song structures out. He went home, he listened to the music. That right there alone is a kid applying themselves. Nothing could have been better. And probably, I must say that day after day as we got into the camp, my heart just got hot from being warmed and rewarmed and rewarmed from every one of those kids coming up to me at some point and showing me how much this meant to them. Every day, the parents coming up and talking to me and showing me how much they really appreciated what was happening to their children sent me home in tears many, many, many nights, where for the first time outside of being on stage, I actually felt something that I only felt when I was on stage. When you've got 13 kids, you've got, or 15 kids, 18 kids, however many kids you've had, you've got a lot of different personalities. However, you also have a lot to do to make these kids social with each other. And, you know, that brings up, again, those words that I've mentioned many times, all right? Empathy, sympathy, compassion. These are the things that happen when kids create. These are the things that happen when kids create together. They walk away and they become stronger. They become stronger and more spiritual in their minds, which enables them to be stronger and more secure people. And what's really cool about music and what's really cool about that creation is regardless of what these kids do, because if you've got 30 kids, maybe one is gonna go on to be a musician. But the other 29 are gonna carry this experience with them and make sure that it applies to the secure person that they're gonna become as they become an adult. And that is what's priceless when you make a child's mind and heart work together. By the 6th, 7th day in, kids were showing up at 4. They kept coming in earlier, and we knew right at that point that we were doing a good thing. And we took it upon ourselves to think, wow, how cool would it be to offer a rock camp year-round, especially in a community like Houghton, where our kids don't have a chance to have their talent developed quite as much as maybe we'd like them to have. And our thought was, wow, what if we could come up with the ability to give these kids 2 rooms filled up with some really good, solid gear, nothing over the top, not completely entry level, but somewhere right in the middle that gave them the ability to really learn instruments, learn creativity, learn songwriting, learn recording, learn how to make your CDs, learn how to do the graphics, learn how to shoot your own videos, and then learn how to put them out. Even how to micro-market yourself, digital marketing, teaching these kids how to get on the computer and learn how to do viral campaigns. All of these things are what we're trying to do at the garage. And I think it's really possible. There's a beautiful thing that's happening here, and I'm totally pleased to be a part of it. Welcome to the garage. Things that we need to make sure the Rock Camp exists year-round is a facility that we can base the garage out of. The next thing we need is gear. The third thing we need is the ability to market our idea and make sure that we have membership. The fourth thing we need to do is say, this is our start day. This is the day we start. And no matter what, we're moving forward from now. We've got the place. We're working on the gear. Outside of that, we have almost everything we need to help these kids and direct them and lead them into being creative. We've got great staff. Again, all the people we had before are on board for more. So it's those pieces that we need to put together right now. All right, that's what we're trying to do with the garage. And if we put those pieces together, this community is going to be highly affected in a positive way. There's no question in my mind, and I don't think there'd be any question in anyone's mind, especially the kids and as well the parents. This has been nothing but a positive impact situation, and I plan on the garage being even more positive as all of our plans come together and we're able to springboard into the future.